Tell us about this vaccine. I believe it's not in human testing yet. Is it likely that you get it through testing and out in time to contain this virus?
Yes. First of all, thank you for having me on. We've done advanced animal testing, and we're ready to start manufacturing. And we are glad that WHO has declared Mpox a global health emergency of international concern. Our vaccine at Tonix is a live virus vaccine, and that allows us to vaccinate potentially many more people at a lower cost. And we think it has the capability of making an impact on public health.
And how long do you see the threat of Mpox remaining? And I mean, extrapolating that out, how big do you think the market could potentially become here?
Well, it's frightening to think about it, but 2 years ago was the most recent public health emergency involving Mpox. And in that, 32,000 Americans have become infected, and it's now endemic in the United States. But this new strain, Clade 1B, which, by the way, was first detected outside of Africa in Sweden yesterday, is expected to come to the United States. This is believed to be more contagious than the Clade 2 that infected 32,000 Americans in the past 2 years, and also approximately 20 times more lethal.
I remember when we were at the start of the COVID outbreak, and Angela Merkel, the Chancellor of Germany at the time, said she thought 60 to 70% of the population could get it, and that sounded insane. Of course, now we've all gotten it. Can Mpox get this bad?
Well, we're still learning about the transmissibility of this Clade 1B variant. But it does seem to be more transmissible than the Clade 2 variant. In the United States, the Clade 2 variant was mostly restricted to men who have sex with men. But in Africa, monkeypox, about 50% of the deaths are in children. So this is not technically a venereal disease, but it is transmitted by contact and also potentially by aerosol. So I can't guess right now how widespread it will become in the United States, but it is hard to imagine that it won't spread in the United States. And in fact, we really don't know. The HHS said yesterday they don't believe the Clade 2, Clade 1B is in the United States yet, but we did, as far as I know, the CDC is not actively testing.
And I want to talk a little bit more about your specific vaccine and the trial that's underway. What type of trial is this, and when might we expect results to be published?
Right. So we haven't started a trial yet. Now we're reinvigorating our efforts because, frankly, interest in Mpox was maintained at Tonix, but not by health authorities or investors. So we're ready to jump on and get going again. But the difference is that ours is a live virus vaccine. It's a modern form. We call it a fourth generation, similar to the vaccine that Edward Jenner introduced in 1800, but we believe with much better tolerability profile, much better, 10,000-fold in animals. And this, when Jenner's vaccine was used to prevent smallpox all over the world, that actually kept Mpox out of the human population. So we think from a public health point of view, a live virus vaccine has the ability to block forward transmission and to be work with only one dose. And that's a big advantage, both in the United States and other countries.